Let's check out more great gadgets at CES Showstoppers 2020. Thanks for joining us, everyone. It is Andrew here from Apple Insider, and CES 2020 is well underway. We are here at Showstoppers, the third big event of CES, bringing you the more of the best gear and gadgets for Apple fans. We are first here at OWC with a bunch of great Mac accessories. This is the Thunder Bay Flex 8. It is a 3-in-1 Thunderbolt 3 storage, dock, and PCI solution that can hold up to 128 terabytes. And of course, you can see the dock on the front that had USB as well as CF Express and an SD card reader. Then moving on here, this is the Thunderbolt 3 Pro dock. There is a CF Fast 2.0 and SD card reader on the front, as well as a USB port, and then additional ports around the back, including eSATA, dual USB ports, an Ethernet port. This is actually a toggle switch for the fan. It can run 30 minutes with the fan off, a lock, those two Thunderbolt 3 ports, as well as DisplayPort and a power port. OWC actually had a bunch of different stuff to show, so we didn't want to go through all of it, but our last thing we wanted to show off was the Akitio Node Titan. This thing is pretty amazing. Now there is a full 650 watts of power here to supply a full-sized graphics card, and it can be completely swapped out and done without any tools, so it's easy to open up, swap out the card, and put a different one in if you ever need to replace it. And then the top actually has a handle, which means it's going to be pulled around, so whether you're going out to a shoot and you're doing some video stuff out on the ground, or you want to take this somewhere, and you want to go game, you want to game on your MacBook Pro, take it with you, and you want a great graphics card with you here. And of course, not just Macs, PCs as well can benefit from an external GPU such as this. So it's a really modular device. It's pretty amazing how well they've done here to fit everything into this compact chassis and made it so easy to swap out those cards when necessary. Of course, this is Thunderbolt 3 equipped, and it'll deliver 85 watts of power to your machine, which is almost enough to top off the fastest MacBook Pro. Then we're moving on to Brilliant. So Brilliant made waves last year at CES when they announced they were bringing HomeKit support to their Brilliant wall panel, what you see here on the left. Now, we still don't have HomeKit support quite yet, but they are working with Apple diligently to make sure that that happens. But this year we have this new switch there on the right hand side. It's very nice, blends well with the rest of the Brilliant ecosystem, has a very similar design aesthetic. It's also very functional, tap it to turn on and off, and then you can slide your finger up and down to dim and brighten the light. It works very smoothly, and we are really excited to try this one out in our own homes. Not only do we have the new single switch to go along, but there also is a smart plug. So we didn't get to check it out in person, but we did have some marketing materials just to see it. Just another smart plug to add to their ecosystem as a whole. Then we saw Castaway. So this made a lot of headlines when it launched on Indiegogo. Basically, they kind of called it a second screen, but just a second device. It's actually a Chromium or a Chrome tablet that connects to your iPhone. So it's in basically kind of a case style design. They snap together and allows you to get a little bit more work done, be a little bit more productive. So you have a phone call coming in, so your phone's up by your ear, and then you can go ahead and use the Castaway tablet to access your contacts or take some notes or whatever it is you need to do. And there's a whole bunch of functionality you can do here. These things turn both opposite directions. You can close it up so they're open on each side. You can separate them and just take your phone if you need to, or bring the tablet. It's USB-C and can actually power your iPhone if necessary. It can turn into a actually separate keyboard, so you can use a larger keyboard to type on but still have your full iPhone screen, or can turn into a game controller and you can use it that way. So there's a lot of applications for this, and a lot of people are really excited to see when it ships, hopefully starting in May. After sticking with the Presidio style for many years, Spec is out with the Presidio 2 line of iPhone cases. These new cases essentially use kind of an airbag style feature to help protect your iPhones. So it's still keeping everything very slim. They're not really increasing the form factor much, but they are adding air bubbles in around those ridges. So the ribs of the case are still there. Those were there before, but now they put a layer of air in between the bottom layer and the top layer of the phone. So when it drops, it kind of acts like compression and the air gets compacted and slows it down a little bit, and it's not going to damage your phone as much. So these should be pretty protective cases because the Presidio is already a very protective case, and now they're adding this new airbag style protection in there as well. So a lot of really cool tech to check out for a case. Over at Mateus, we have these wireless aluminum keyboards. They are very stylish keyboards, obviously, because they look pretty similar to Apple's, but they're kind of picking up where Apple left off. So as far as the wireless version goes, it's actually one of those 3-in-1 keyboards that can connect to multiple devices. They were one of the first ones to launch a 3-in-1 keyboard like this, so that not particularly new, but they do a good job of implementing Apple style and kind of filling in some of the features that were missing, such as the wired aluminum keyboard. Apple completely discontinued that, but they were here to fill in that gap, bringing you back a wireless keyboard that has Apple's classic design, but you can plug it in if that's something you'd prefer. Then on the kind of wild end of the spectrum, they have a more ergonomic keyboard like this. It's very adjustable, and this, as well as all the others, come both in Windows and PC variants, so if you're not on that Apple train. Lastly, we are looking at MPOW. This is a really cool set of headphones that doubles as a speaker. So it actually closes up and it looks basically like a speaker. Use it as a speaker, and then if you need to, fold it open and pull the headphones out, and you can use the headphones. So it's basically hiding headphones. It's a wireless charging case for the headphones, but it also can act as a loudspeaker. So really unique design here. I'm not sure if you're going to love it or hate it, but it is definitely something unique that we have not seen before, and we just had to stop and check it out just for a few minutes. This is just their prototype, but it seemed very cool, and I'm interested to see how it's going to sound, both as well as the headphones and the case loudspeaker itself. So that's our favorite gear that we found this year at Showstoppers, but I really want to hear what you guys think. Let me know down below in the comments which one of these was your favorite new product, or just reach me on Twitter at Andrew_OSU, and stay tuned for more CES coverage.
Hey everyone, did you guys like that video? Be sure to click on that like button so we can create content that we know that you guys want to see. And follow Apple Insider on all social media channels. If you want the best prices on any Apple gear, check out the Apple Insider price guide that is updated daily. And until next time, we'll see you later.